Congratulations to the Gold Helmet winners, and glad to be back here again. Yeah, we finished up our season on Saturday, and it was we finished up in strong fashion with a 44-16 victory over Pace, and it was an exciting day for us because we got word that we had the help that we needed in the middle of the third quarter, so we were able to finish out the game and lock up the league championship, which is only the second league championship in Merrimack history. So we were very excited about that. It's a bittersweet weekend. We knew we were a long shot, but we were hoping we would get some good news on Sunday from the playoff committee, but we did not get that news. But it doesn't diminish anything that our kids have accomplished this year. You look back, 2 years ago, Merrimack was coming off a 4-6 season when we took over as a staff, and it seemed a long way away, and the kids really paid the price the last 2 years. We picked to finish fifth in our conference last year. We finished third. We picked to finish third this year, and we finished first. So, to do that, it's really a tribute to our kids and the hard work that they've put in over the last couple of years. And as Coach had mentioned, the seniors are a huge part of that. And our seniors gave us a lot of leadership this year, and we were really excited about that. On the defensive side of the ball, we really started to turn the corner as the season went on, and we finished the season with 15 shutout quarters, which is more than a third of our season. So we're excited to build on that, and we got the majority of our defense coming back next season. All our statistical leaders are sophomores or younger. We had Sean Loizo, who's a sophomore, led the country in tackles. We had Nick Desjardins, who had 5.5 sacks for us as a sophomore. We had our Jason Fisher, who's a sophomore, who was second in our conference in interceptions. And then Tony Johnson, who's also a sophomore, had a monster year again. He's already broken the career record in sacks at Merrimack in just 2 years. He has 21.5 sacks in 2 years. He's just a beast. He had second in the country in tackles for a loss this year, after last year as a freshman leading, finishing second in sacks in the country. Offensively, it was a huge year for us. We again are doing it with a lot of young kids, which is why the future at Merrimack is bright. We're losing two senior wide receivers that own every record in the history of Merrimack. They're 1, 2, or 3 in every statistical category, both of them, and we'll miss them in the future, Chris Laham and Jeremiah Watts. But we have a lot of great players come back. The first time in my coaching career, we're going to have the entire offensive line back from an offensive line that we were fourth in the country in rushing offense at 251 yards per game. We also, in addition to that, led our conference in least amount of sacks, which Steve would tell you that's a big one for the quarterback. We only gave up 11 sacks and one sack per every 36 attempts, which is really amazing. I always joke with our quarterbacks, they wear red shirts all week long, so they basically get hit once a week, so that's a great thing for them. Our sophomores, again, on offense, Anthony Smalls was fourth in the country in rushing at 145 yards per game. James Suazo, our quarterback, was sixth in the country in total offense at 335 yards per game. He was the third leading rusher in the conference, second in touchdowns scored, as well as leading in touchdown passes. So the future is really bright for us. We're really excited that we have a championship. And we're excited that we have something to look forward to, because next year we're going to take that big step to get into the playoffs and ultimately win a national championship. Maybe we'll borrow those blue pants. Thank you very much.